I'm John Snow, and welcome to the New Horizon Youth Centre. This is some place. It's a day centre for vulnerable and homeless young people, sort of 16 to 21 years old. But welcome especially to the Amy Winehouse Foundation. And we are just amazed because we are a very early and very substantial beneficiary. She's left us a wonderful legacy here, which is going to keep the young people here fed, not only with food, but with music.
I'm Sheila O'Connor, I'm director of New Horizon Youth Centre. We're based here in between Euston Station and St Pancras. We're a day centre working with young homeless people, young people who are vulnerable or at risk in some way. Over the course of a year, we see up to 2,000 young people, and we work with them to create opportunities for their future, to inspire, to motivate them. So creating positive futures for young people is really our motto. A lot of the activities we put on here are around building self-esteem and self-confidence, and that's where music comes in. Music's very important to every young person who comes through the door, as it is to all of us. And the Amy Winehouse Foundation has agreed to fund a music tutor here at the centre. This means we can double the amount of music we're putting on.
And the story I tell about her is we went to St Lucy when she was beginning her recovery, and there was seven horses on the beach that the horses he'd rent them out to tourists, but he wouldn't let the local kids go on them. So what Amy did was she took all the horses for a month and put the local kids on. That's how much she loved kids. So when I got there, he wanted $15,000. I said, I've only got $2,000, if that'll do. So she was very generous and very charitable. Not just the children, she loved everybody. She was just a normal kid. But her legacy, apart from her wonderful music, is going to be to change the lives of children and young people for the better.
More than that, baby, I've been here for 40 years. Yeah, ever since 1970. I am an extremely ancient croc. If I am any good as a journalist, it is very much because of New Horizon, because it keeps me rooted, it gives me something very much to contrast with the world in which I mix. You could easily, you know, lose any sense of how life is for people who are challenged and who are vulnerable and who have very little. You see a lot of people who have a lot, and you could easily get carried away and forget, you know, the rest of the world. But this keeps me rooted, and it gives me something to sort of balance things against. And it's an uplifting place to come. Amy was somebody for everybody. You know, I loved her music. You know, young people here loved her music. You know, it's across society, and therefore the fact that the foundation reaches out to a very important part of her constituency, of people who loved her music. He's absolutely right. It's a lovely way to remember her.
The New Horizons Youth Centre, for £35,368 only.
Only. And let me say, an enormous thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
I'm Rohan, 21 years of age, aka Sneaker. And you're at the New Horizon Youth Centre with the Amy Winehouse Foundation, and basically I come here by 10:15 if I want to do my housing. If I don't, I come at 10:30 because we have to leave the show at actually 9, so there's not much to do. So we come here 10:30, by 4 it's closed, so I have to go, 4 o'clock. The show actually opens back up 4 o'clock, so we can go there. But we have to definitely be in by 7 for dinner. If you're under 21 and you need somewhere to go, then this is a good place to start. This can get you help with housing, physical fitness, studio if you're into it, art, there's internet access, there's lunch and breakfast, and you can get training help as well. I write music every day. I wish I could be in the studio every day. I sleep in it. I write about my life and its experiences. It's funny, like when I used to write when I was a bit younger, it was all about girls and I take this one out or something like that. But now it's more about my struggle. Like, not a lot of people understand what we go through, like being homeless or being less fortunate. And I just want everyone to be awake and aware of what's going on around them. This Pilion Trust is open, great people. Like, I love them so much that they actually make me feel like family instead of just their workers and we're clients. Yeah.
Day after day, I have to slave away to meet the peeps, reside in a better place. Cause the government's got me struggling, hustling, got me lost in a little
few. Well, lucky enough, we're fortunate enough to be able to open our shelter. We were able to open it Friday because Friday was the third day that it was below zero. Rules are, we don't get funding unless the weather is below zero for 3 days. So at the moment it's really cold, I think it's below two, minus two now. So I think we've got them open until Sunday, but unfortunately when the weather goes up, then our funding will stop. Once it goes up from below zero, our funding will stop.
And then that
funding is coming from Islington Council, from the government really. But if we want to open any more, we're going to have to fund ourselves. And normally we will be able to do that for a week or so, but not on a long-term basis. So in a way, we pray for the weather to be a bit cold so then we can keep them indoors, you know, rather than... Because even though it goes up over there below zero, it doesn't mean to say it's still freezing out there.
Hi, I'm Shola Ammar, and I'm down here at the shelter today because a friend of mine who has helped me through my journey works down here, and I thought it'd be really cool to come along and get involved. I think it's important to do more stuff like this in the community. I don't think there's enough of it, so it's really impressive to see.